stressed out. I'm so cold, it's raining. It is not a fun night. Considering the route I'm taking, anywhere I go, it's going to be mountainous and rainy. Camp. Have a fun moment. Good morning. Man, did I get lucky last night. Holy shit. Literally minutes after I was bitching to the camera about how shitty life is, I go down the road to the town of Lestan, and I go into a bar just to ask for some water. I have my water bottle, and I end up first getting a coffee, and then a sandwich for the road, and then Paco, an amazing guy, invites me to stay with him and his family. We hang out at the bar, and then have a great night indoors, warm bed. In the morning, I go back to the bar, coffee. He makes me a huge breakfast with bacon, eggs, some delicious sausage. I ate a lot, and they gave me some pointers on which direction to go, so now I'm on this dirt road, more or less, but it seems doable so far.
Wicked and evil while casting a spell, my love was deep for this Mexican maiden. I was in love, but in vain I could tell. One night a wild young cowboy came in, wild as the West Texas wind.
Woo! Not too bad for this fucking thing, hey? She's got some wide hips back there, but she goes. Alright, so I'm a bit farther down the road here. It's been a muddy mess. I climbed that mountain up there from the other side. I shoved this bike up the muddy hill. It was pretty rough, but at least since there, I've been able to come downhill. Though, as you see, I've been getting a little muddy. Check me out.
Many thoughts race through my mind as I stood there. I had one chance and that was to
This is fun. This is a good time. I'm getting nowhere, but I'm having a good time. And I'm not cold yet. I'll keep going. Hey there. Oh, didn't even see that there. Hello. I just went through the town of Ripoll, which is kind of the junction town. I'm heading that way. It will save me about a day of riding and a day of cold, basically. I'm on a little path here, which is pretty nice. It's going to go to a town just a few kilometers away. They're supposed to be in Albergue, which is a cheap, simple hostel meant for pilgrims of the Camino de Santiago. Snow-capped mountain, very nice, nice touch. I've only seen them from afar. Tomorrow I will be getting to know them a bit more intimately as I'll be climbing to, I think, a little bit over 1,500 meters. And at that point I will then be in France, which is pretty cool. I haven't even really considered that yet. That's exciting, something to look forward to.
The Albergue was closed in town. So I looked on my map and I found a campsite that was another 5 kilometers down the road. So it was starting to get dark, so I fucking got back on the bike, hustled my way down the highway, got to the campsite. It's closed. There's a car outside it, so I think someone's here. I think I might take refuge in the washrooms again, because that's the shit. Shelter, there's water, electricity. It's pretty much a free hotel. But this still has that whole break and enter and type of feel, so it's a little sketchy. Shouldn't be a problem unless someone is here and they come to use the female bathroom. I'm sleeping in the female one, which if someone finds me will make it even weirder, but it's just the way it works out. It's better. Girls always have the better bathroom. As soon as after I stop talking to you, well, you're a camera, so I stopped talking to myself. You know, Someone's having a fire right up there. I think it's indoors. I think Buddy lives up there. I don't know. Best would be to go ask. The only problem there is the possibility of a no would be really troublesome right now. Oh, god dang, that's beautiful. Look at the pink back there. Can you see that? Wow, I think that's a sign.
I spent the night in the toilet there.
Check out Buck Abroad on Instagram, where you can find some sweet pics from behind the scenes of this video, along with many more great shots and stories from my travels. Dig a little deeper into Buck Abroad on YouTube and check out my adventure motorcycle series featuring a 40,000 kilometer solo trip through some of the sketchiest countries on the globe. If you get a kick out of these videos, please make sure to like, send some positive vibes, share with a friend, and subscribe for more. Thanks.